We've inserted this new slide to correct an omission in the original webinar. If you have a data set that has mixed sequence types, namely mRNA or cDNA, and then also genomic DNA sequences, these must be done as two separate submissions. You cannot have a data file that has mixed sequence types. We did this for the ease of showing the data in the webinar, but I just wanted to make sure that you understood that you need to do these as two separate submissions. And now let's talk for a few minutes about how you actually add the annotation in the two submission tools. Again, our submitter says that they need help, and basically the help that they need is how to do it in the submission tool. So this is their beta tubulin sequence. The exons are highlighted. And what we want to do is to get from this with the specific nucleotide numbers to the features that we see in a GenBank display record. In the display record, you'll see the word join, the parenthesis, and then the groups of nucleotide numbers. Recognize that this is only in the display format. When you define the nucleotide numbers, you will do that in the feature table without the word join, and we will show that a little bit later in the video. There are two main submission tools, BankIt or Sequin, and then depending on how you want to do the annotation, you have other paths that you can take, one choice or the other. So we're going to first talk about BankIt. And this slide just gives you the specific steps. What we plan to do when the webinar recording is made available is to have a file with specific screenshots. But these are the basic steps that you would need to do if you're going to do the feature annotation by using the input forms. If you're going to use a feature table, then these are the steps that you need to do in BankIt. And this is the feature table format. I already showed you that for the data set for data example number 3. And it's important that you create your feature table as plain text. And in the second BankIt submissions webinar, we discussed feature table files in detail. So I refer you back to that video if you need more information. In the BankIt submission tool, when you have your feature annotation correctly done, you will see this display for each sequence in your data set. And it's important that you consider doing a blastp analysis. You can copy this translation and do a blastp analysis. You get a lot of hits, and that's again because we are doing the sequence determination of a commonly used molecular marker. You can also do the feature annotation with Sequin, and again, there are two different paths, and these are the steps that you would then do if you're going to do it by individual features, where you add each of the set of features, or you can use a feature table file. Again, the feature table format is the same for both Sequin and BankIt. So again, you can use one of the two submission tools, and depending on your data, you may then find one path would be easier or more efficient than the other path. One of the questions that you might want to try to understand then is, when do you want to use Sequin? Well, both BankIt and Sequin will accept multiple sequences. You can use a feature table file to do that. But you want to use Sequin if you already have an alignment. BankIt does not take alignments, and the formats that are accepted in Sequin are listed there. Sequin can also generate an alignment for you. And when you do have an alignment, one of the features in Sequin is that you can annotate a single sequence and then copy that annotation to the rest of the sequences in your data set. But the quality of the alignment affects how well that works. Sometimes you need to do some manual adjustment. Sometimes you might need to extract a feature table and then modify it and then use a feature table to actually do the final annotation. But if you have multiple closely related sequences that are high quality, you may want to use Sequin. More information about Sequin is available here from the URL listed. So just to go through some of the troubleshooting and error reports, I mentioned earlier about doing a blastp analysis with the translation that you get from BankIt or from Sequin. I had a submitter just recently contact me for help, the help desk, and the person was indeed using the common molecular markers, beta tubulin and TEF1. And I took the protein translation from the submission and did a blastp analysis for each one. And this is the blast results that I got, which if the person is studying beta tubulin and TEF1, you would expect good hits because we have a lot of the data in the databases. And as it turned out, the person had the wrong CDS feature annotation for their sequences. When you do the correct CDS feature, this was the result for the beta tubulin. So again, if you're studying the common molecular markers, you're going to get coverage over your entire sequence, and you're going to get good hits. This is a purple score only because the length of the protein that I submitted. So always do a blastp analysis with your translation. There's also a new experimental protein blast analysis called Smart Blast. You can find it in the specialized blast section on the homepage. And Peter Cooper will be doing a webinar about Smart Blast on September 2nd. So you can get information about that webinar from the webinars page. That link was shown at the very beginning of today's webinar. The errors that you get from BankIt, you may get a translation problem in the sense of an internal stop codon if you have the CDS feature annotation information wrong. BankIt will not check for the GTAG pairs, so that is something that BankIt does not do. However, Sequin will give you the internal stop error termination codon premature, but it will also tell you when the splice donor consensus is not found in the CDS feature annotation. When GenBank receives submissions that have problems in their initial review of the submission, they will send a letter back to the submitter with this information, and that is where you need to do some further checking and investigation of your sequences. One other thing you can do in Sequin is when you are in the record view or the GenBank display format, if you double click anywhere in the sequence, you will then open the view of the sequence, and this already has the CDS annotated, and you can then see easier the GT and the AG that is off on this CDS annotation. So the fact that there's this little blue arrow means that the CDS is going through this G, and then it is picking up at this G. It's missing the G that is actually the start of the exon. So that is something else that you can do in Sequin, is to actually see how the feature is annotated on your sequence. So we've gone through all of the items that we listed on the outline. And if you do have any additional comments or feedback to provide, please write to webinars@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov. And again, please write to info@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov if you do have questions about your submission.